In this video, I will be reviewing the CCK KF1912 vegetable cleaver. Hello guys, I'm Chef Panko and I used to work in a Japanese restaurant. Make sure to subscribe to know more about cooking and knives. Before we start with the review, I want to go over some disclosures. The CCK knives in this video have been bought with my own money. No one is paying me to make this video or to include their knife in a video. If this video provided any value, make sure to hit the like button since that will help the channel a lot. Before you buy a CCK cleaver, you must know that CCK has changed the logo design. The version in this video is the old stamped logo that contains all the information about their shop. It includes the size number, shop location, phone number, and it is part of the history of Chanchi-K. The new batches for 2021 have been replaced with a lasered logo instead of stamped, which wipes away the history and characteristics that made the CCK special with the old batches of knives. Everything else is the same, so make sure you contact the seller and ask which batch you get before ordering. CCK also has changed the packaging. The old batch has a paper wrap around the knife, and they replaced it with a cardboard box. Chanchi-K has many variations and types of knives. This version I'm reviewing in this video is a vegetable cleaver, or known as a slicer. It is thin and lightweight and sharpened at a lower angle compared to its dual-purpose cleaver. The choil on the Chanchi-K is nicely done and thin behind the edge. The knife will go smoothly through root vegetables without splitting them. The taper at the choil is slightly thicker than the front taper of this knife. Therefore, you get a sharper performance at the front, and the heel is excellent on denser food. Food with high water content will stick to your blade, but there's pretty much no resistance while slicing through food with high water content. Over time, the food release will be better since you will build natural scratch patterns on the blade. Another option is to add scratch patterns with some sandpaper or whetstone. The knife is sharpened at a 20 degree angle per side. The blade has durable stainless steel, so you don't have to worry about chipping. CCK has no information about the Rockwell hardness. However, during my testing, the knife feels like a Rockwell of around 58 to 59. Combined with the knife's 20 degree sharpened angle, the knife edge can last approximately 4 to 5 months with regular honing sessions before needing whetstone maintenance. The knife comes with a weight of 270 grams. The blade does have a distal spine tapering. The thickness at the heel is 2.0 mm, the middle and the front is 1.5 mm. The Chanchi-K has a hidden fill tang wooden handle. The handle of the knife is pretty much untreated and dry. I do recommend adding some mineral oil to the handle. The overall finish on the handle could do a better job. There's no perfect seal from the brass bolster either. The knife balance point of this knife is at the front, which assists you in the up and down motion. The blade profile is on the flat side, but the heel and the front have a slight curve to prevent you from digging into your cutting board. The curves also give you the ability to rock on herbs. The Chanchi-K KF1912 is an excellent vegetable cleaver, especially if you like a straight blade profile. The stainless steel is also quite durable. It is one of the lightest vegetable cleaver I have tried in this size, and they achieved this by adding a distal spine taper. The wooden handle is pretty rough and untreated, but the brass bolster is very comfortable. However, the overall fit and finish could be better, especially around the handle area. Unfortunately, the online prices are very steep and you will be paying a premium. That's it for this video. If you have any questions or other opinions, leave them in the comment section below. If I provided any value, please give this video a thumbs up since that will help the channel. If you want to know more about cooking and knives, please subscribe and hit the bell to get notified. Thank you for watching, and I see you in the next video.